What's going on, everyone? Thanks so much for coming back to the Clever TV studio. I'm Dana Ward with Joslyn Davis.
Hello.
And we are quite excited to have one of the stars of the brand new ABC Family show, Switched at Birth, in the studio today. It's Katie Leclerc.
Hello.
Hello. You guys are off to an amazing, amazing start. Just a few episodes in, I feel like people are already like obsessed with the show.
I hope so. I'm obsessed with the show, so it's good to hear that other people are enjoying it.
People out there that haven't had the chance to tune in yet, how would you kind of briefly describe it? Because it's very, it's complex.
It is. There's a lot of layers going on. It's about two girls who went home with the wrong families at the hospital. And one of the families is very, very wealthy and takes over their city. And then the other family comes from a very working class neighborhood, single parent mother. And she also had the additional struggle of raising a deaf child as well. So I play a deaf character, and the two families find out about it, and they decide that the best solution is for everyone to get to know each other. So we move into the same property, and this pressure cooker starts to heat up a little bit, and it's gonna explode here pretty soon.
Oh, yeah. I feel like so far your character Daphne has been very nice and just like going with the flow. Are we going to see her burst out, and like, are we gonna see a new side to her pretty soon?
I think that some of the character choices the writers have decided to take us might surprise people. But for the most part, I think that, you know, Daphne's had to struggle a lot in her life, and she had to work to get where she is. And that might not be so much the case with Bay. So the two characters are very polar opposites of each other. And I think it's a good dynamic to see, you know, how they react to each other, and it's a hard situation for everyone.
Definitely. And we actually had Vanessa Morano in the studio, your co-star, not too long ago.
Absolutely.
And we were asking her, we were like, how did they ever find an actress to co-star with you who knows American Sign Language? And so tell the viewers that might not know kind of your history.
Absolutely. I learned sign language when I was 17. I just took it as an elective in high school. I needed a foreign language to graduate, and my sister is an ASL teacher, so I was like, well, that'd be fun. I could communicate with her. And when I was 20, I found out that I have something called Meniere's disease, and that has, it's a problem with fluid retention in the inner ear. So I get pressure in the ear, ringing in the ear, fluctuating hearing loss, and attacks of vertigo. Which can be challenging sometimes.
Yeah, that's hard. That's like nausea and stuff too,
exactly, right? Where the room just starts to spin. It's sometimes challenging, but my attacks happen mostly at night, so it usually doesn't interfere with production too bad, and if it does, they're very aware of the Meniere's disease and very, very accommodating, sweet people.
That's great. And I think what's so cool, like the added layer to the show of your character being deaf, is that it's really educating people out there. Like, we were even talking about in our studio, like, what's the right term, or what's the right way to say something or whatnot.
Absolutely.
And your show is really doing that for viewers out there of all ages.
Absolutely. You know, it's really cool because they bring up questions like nature versus nurture and socioeconomic issues and racial issues and all that stuff. And it almost seems like the deaf stuff is sort of secondary because it's really about the families. And then you get this other world where you see this rich, beautiful language and culture and very proud people, and they're never the victim, ever.
Right.
Daphne's a product of her environment, and she just thrives and flourishes wherever she is. And I think that's my favorite part about her.
Now, you had mentioned that you were already fluent in American Sign Language. But you called it an accent that you actually have on the show. How did you go about preparing for that? I feel like that would be really difficult learning any sort of accent.
Yeah.
Right. It was crazy hard at first.
I'm going to be honest here,
I'm going to tell you the truth. It was really difficult, but we sat down really early on with the producers and a dialect coach, and we sat down and said, where is Daphne's hearing loss? And sort of mapped it out and said what sounds she could say and what sounds she couldn't say and what they would replace that with. So like, P's turn into B's, and I don't say S's. And it's very subtle, and they want it to be very subtle because they want, you know, the viewers at large to be able to understand her. But it's definitely a part of the culture, and you know, she gets made fun of a lot because of that. And it's hard. It's hard to be different, and kids are mean.
Definitely.
So It's a big challenge for me as an actor to show up and remember my lines and all this stuff, and mm-hmm. to speak in sign language and to speak in English and to listen to myself at the same time for the accent, and there's a lot going on.
Congratulations, seriously. Oh, I mean, sometimes I can barely talk just like this. Yeah, that's amazing.
Well, I hear you. I'm that way too.
Now, I definitely want to talk about the cast, because the cast on this show is off the charts. But first, can we just start with all the boys?
I know.
Oh, absolutely.
Guys, on the show. What's that like?
That's a good looking guy.
We have some eye candy. It's distracting sometimes, I'll be honest. We have Blair Redford on the show right now. He plays Ty, who's Bay's love interest. We have Charles Michael Davis on the show. We'll, you know, not to give too much away, but we'll later on, we'll get Austin Butler.
Ooh, cool.
Who's adorable.
Yeah,
oh
definitely.
My God, I love him. And we have, I'm trying to think, we have Sean Birdie with those crazy blue eyes that mm-hmm. just pop out at you. And you know, ABC Family does a really good job of casting hunky boys.
Yeah, they don't mess around. They know they're doing. Is there anyone who you would love to see on the show who hasn't been there yet?
Oh, boy. You know, I really just trust the writers, and whoever they pick, I'm sure he's going to be amazing.
So far,
good
so
call.
Good, right?
So far, so good.
And then, of course, Constance Marie and Leah Thompson. I mean,
absolutely.
Icons. It's amazing.
Absolutely. You know, they cast very funny people for a very dramatic show, so it gives great opportunity for comedy. I definitely feel like viewers can laugh and cry in the same episode. We do.
Yeah, seriously.
So it's good, you know, and Constance learning sign language, she was not fluent before this show, but if you watch the show, you'd have no idea. She's
natural.
Working so hard. And Leah, who I love, I've loved her since I was a kid, and turns out we look exactly alike.
It's no big deal.
Kind of crazy and sort of an exciting moment for me when I heard Leah Thompson was involved. And
yeah.
D.W. Moffat from Friday Night Lights, holy cow, he's awesome. But Lucas Grabeel was probably my most exciting.
Are you a High School Musical fan? You can tell us.
I'm such a fan. I actually listened to, before the audition, I have this ritual where I turn the music on as loud as I can and just sing and dance and go crazy in my car.
That's a nice
before, before like every audition. So before Switched at Birth, I turned on I Want It All from High School Musical 3. And then I walked in the room and Lucas is standing there looking at me. And I'm like, oh my gosh, this
it was
is crazy.
A sign.
Right? Exactly.
So did you tell him? I was just listening.
Not at that time, because I was like sort of in shock and like couldn't breathe and my heart was pounding.
Yeah.
But I told him afterwards and he laughed. He's such a good sport.
Oh man.
In the show, you are like totally really good at basketball. I guess you take after your biological father on the show.
Mm-hmm.
Are you actually really athletic in real life, or are there many, many takes that have to be had?
Well, I'm kind of athletic, you could say. I played basketball when I was a kid and into high school, and I make some shots.
Okay.
Yeah, what was the audition?
Off.
I know, what was the audition like? Because there's so many different things required of your character. Sign language and, of course, basketball, not to mention, you know, doing a scene with someone else. What was the process like?
Yeah, well, they actually had a nationwide casting call for the roles of Daphne and Emmett.
Okay.
So I feel very honored and very blessed to be able to be chosen.
Mm-hmm.
But the audition was really sort of a normal kind of audition that, you know, like every other TV
mm-hmm.
show. I walked in and I was signing from the very beginning because I wanted them to see that I could sign. And my first audition, I didn't have an accent, and the second one, they said, you know, what do you think about it? And you know, it's a very sensitive thing. I don't normally speak with an accent, but
mm-hmm.
since I'm involved in the deaf community and deaf culture, we wanted to make sure that we walked that line very carefully, and
mm-hmm.
I feel like we do it respectfully. And so they had us do that for the second one, and then the third audition with a screen test, I got to do it with Constance.
Oh, wow.
And I didn't have the part yet, and I was like, oh my gosh, Constance Marie is here, and it was so great and crazy, and then we got the phone call, and things went from there.
That is so cool.
So where are we at right now? How much have you shot? What's done? What can we look forward to?
We're just about to finish this set of the season. We're just about to finish episode 10.
So you know everything that's going on.
Everything so far. There are so many secrets. I wish I could tell you.
Really? The thing that I really want to know about is that, you know, your mom on the show, Constance, she doesn't want to reveal at this point who the father of her baby, aka Bay, is. But also, you know, your character's father growing up. Are we going to get any answers, or can you tell us anything about that situation?
I can tell you baby that, baby daddy.
Yeah, what's going on?
Baby daddy is a very interesting character. And there's a lot of backstory that goes along with maybe why she doesn't want to reveal secrets right now. And she's got very good reasons for that. So look forward to that.
Most definitely. And of course, we want to know, are you working on anything else?
Right now, I've just been so crazy busy and very focused on this that I've just been trying to do the best job possible, and definitely looking forward to work in the future, but just finishing this one up strong first.
Right, right. This might sound stupid, but I gotta ask. I feel like when you're learning a new language, people usually ask, well, what's the easiest thing I can learn? Whoever's not learning, is there something you can teach us in American Sign Language that is like everyone should know sort of thing?
Bathroom.
Oh, just like
that's
this?
A good one.
Yeah.
Bathroom. Am I doing it right?
Yep, you got it.
Bathroom.
It's the letter T and then you shake it. So like toilet.
Okay, cool. Uh-huh. Right? Oh, sweet. Okay.
And then I'll show you my favorite sign. It's mosquito.
Oh, I like this.
Because they dig into your skin.
I hope there's no mosquitoes in the bathroom.
How would you describe it?
Oftentimes, American Sign Language uses gestures that you might already be using.
Okay.
And so it really is sort of like user-friendly. And if you watch it, there's a lot of times where if you don't know sign language, you'll have no idea what they're talking about. But certain, you know, once you get familiar with it, there's certain like through lines, like across the board, like certain similarities with like team and group and class are all like the same movement with just the letter of that word.
Oh,
right.
See.
So that kind of, or family,
same movement, but
the
with
same,
first
yeah.
Letter.
So okay. There'll be a lot of like recurring hand shapes or movements or things like that. And then there's ones that just have like no sense at all. But like one that you guys might appreciate, in the film industry, you hear the term check the gate all the time, right? Like when you're done filming and they want to make sure that everything's great, they have like the lens, the camera lens, right? And then you check the gate.
Oh, I like that.
That's really neat.
Checking the gate.
Check the gate.
Checking the gate. It's pretty
fun. Oh, I love this. That's
awesome.
Love learning.
I'm curious to know also on the show, outside of work or, you know, maybe behind the scenes, who have you really bonded with as far as the other actors on the show go?
Well, we all went to Lucas's house for the premiere, and that was really fun to sort of just kick back, you know.
No work.
No work. Just be ourselves and hang out. And Vanessa and I have gotten pretty close. The other night we were shooting until like 2 in the morning, and we were both very tired. So we decided to call each other and drive home while speaking to each other. And it's nice
That's
to just
smart.
Not have to really talk, but know that someone else is there keeping you alive.
Because you're shooting in LA, but on the outskirts of LA, right?
Absolutely. So it's kind of a drive home, but you know, we've really become this very supportive family. And in family, there's oftentimes competitive nature.
Of course.
And everybody wants to do their best job. But I go to work and I see Constance with her sign language abilities learning like 5 times faster than I did. And I'm like, dang it. I want to be like that. And so I bring myself to the table with, you know, a little bit of extra competitive and like wanting to be better. And then she wants to be better. And we keep challenging each other. And it's great.
That's a great way to learn, too.
Yeah, absolutely.
Seriously, turn it into a little competition for fun, of course.
Absolutely.
Have you been recognized or anything like that yet from the show, or had any fun moments? What happened?
Sean Birdie and I went to a deaf convention, festival kind of thing, and a few people came up to us, oh, you switched at birth? Yeah. Oh, we're so excited.
That's so cool.
That was cool. And then Lucas Grabiel's launching his music career, so he's been having a couple shows around town, and you know, it's great, again, the whole family sort of bonding and supporting each other. Like, the entire cast went to his show, and
oh, that's so cool.
A lot of people were like, oh my gosh, everyone is here.
The whole cast.
Exactly. So it's nice. It's
that's
very
really
cool.
Neat.
That is neat.
Well, we love the show. I mean,
I know.
I'm hooked for sure. I'll be tuning in every week. So
we
there
will.
Better be
we
more
will.
Episodes.
We sit there and watch it together and dish.
I love it.
So
love
awesome.
It. Episode 4 is the next one, and it's like the fireworks go off and they go crazy.
What kind of fireworks? Like love or fight?
Love, fights.
All of the above.
Absolutely, all of the above. There's a lot of interesting character choices in the next episode.
Thank you.
Well, we're there. Hopefully you guys are there too.
Yay!
Thanks so much for tuning in to Clever TV, guys. I'm Dana Ward with Joslyn Davis and Katie Leclerc. Make sure you tune in to Clever TV for all the info on Switched at Birth and all of your favorite TV shows. We'll see you soon.
Bye, guys.